It was a scheme intended to claw back money, said to have been overpaid to clients of Centrelink. But Robodebt turned out to be a cruel and vicious scandal which targeted thousands of vulnerable Australians, ruthlessly stripping their bank accounts of cash that was rightfully theirs. Today, the findings of the Royal Commission into the scheme were released. It was scathing of Scott Morrison and several of his former ministers, as well as senior public servants. It also recommended criminal or civil prosecutions, although it did not name those it says should be charged.
Straight-faced and straight to the point, the Royal Commissioner hand-delivering her explosive 990-page report into the Robodebt disaster.
The Robodebt scheme was a gross betrayal and a human tragedy.
The Royal Commission describing it as a crude and cruel mechanism, neither fair nor legal, and it made people feel like criminals. It was a costly failure of public administration in both human and economic terms.
It was wrong. It was illegal. It should never have happened, and it should never happen again.
I think it's really interesting that her findings have really shone a spotlight on who the real criminals are.
Between 2015 and 2019, botched computer-generated income averaging wrongly raised $1.7 billion in debt against 433,000 welfare recipients. At least three people committed suicide over the financial stress. Felicity de Somerville considered it too when thousands of dollars were wiped from her bank account. Today, while vindicated, she's mourning fellow victims not here to see the findings.
I think that we've done them a good justice. We've fought the fight that they couldn't fight, that they would have.
Is a report which shows how the previous government and senior public servants hurt, not helped citizens.
The report grilled former social service ministers for their role in the saga, Christian Porter, Stuart Robert, Alan Tudge and Scott Morrison, who's currently holidaying in Italy and the only one of them still in Parliament. His evidence dismissed as untrue. He failed to meet his ministerial responsibility to ensure that Cabinet was properly informed about what the proposal actually entailed and to ensure that it was lawful.
An extraordinary comment about a former Prime Minister.
Do you think it's appropriate that Scott Morrison continue to sit in Parliament?
Well, that's a matter for him.
The Coalition's response.
The government's trying to squeeze every political drop out of it.
This is not the end of it. A chapter's been left out of here, a sealed section referring individuals for civil and criminal prosecution. It'll be submitted to Australian Federal Police and the National Anti-Corruption Commission. The names listed in there will stay secret, at least for now, as not to jeopardise any potential court proceedings.
If people are going to be investigated for potential criminal sanctions from here or in, it's important that they get procedural fairness and a fair trial.
Victims wrongly made to feel like criminals want those responsible behind bars.
Anyone who thinks otherwise doesn't have a conscience.
Now, Scott Morrison has just released a statement, and while he's expressing his regret for the unintended consequences of Robodebt, he is flat out rejecting the adverse findings made against him, saying they're wrong, unsubstantiated, suggesting the Royal Commission doesn't understand how government works. While there are constantly rumours that he's preparing to resign from Parliament for tonight, he remains the member for Cook.
Much more still to come. Chloe Burris, thank you.